Hey there, hope you're doing good. We'll be continuing our refactoring of the Futurecam code. We have a task that talks about classlet. See if we have any classlets. Class var. Class func. Nothing else to do. Basically, static and class are variants of each other in Swift. Let's try to maybe remove some functionality now for a change. Let's remove the HDR functionality. We're not actually removing the functionality, we're removing the code. Anyway, it's not exposed to the user. We are trying out a lot of things, wrote code for a whole bunch of cases, and a lot of it still remains in the code base. This goes away. Oops. HDR bubble. Deleting code is always a good feeling, isn't it? This is always going to be false. Prefer to make changes step by step. Then, because it's false, I remove this and just keep the else. Declare variables at the point of initialization. Great, that is done. Today let's go on a deletion spree. Dual photo. So the dual photo functionality in iOS is something that you take a photo and you get a photo with both the wide and telephoto cameras at the same time. That's an API feature. Again, code has been written, it's not been used, it's just hanging around like a zombie, so that should be gotten rid of. Yeah, you can see it has a whole bunch of issues like low quality photos being delivered. don't crash trying to raw should also be removed. This is not, whoever wrote this didn't bother to properly. Case it. Yeah, this is a different thing. It has nothing to do with dual camera. Okay. So basically it has to be enabled in two places. One is on the photo output, that too after checking if it is supported. Secondly, on the settings, so we have taken care of. Remove dual photo. Okay, let's see what we can do next. Yes, we'll remove raw format. Let's start with the camera duplicate. Oh, quite a lot. Oh, some of them are matching ultra wide RAW. Okay, never mind. Let's just go in order. Do we need this? Is raw photo is false, so guard false, else of course you can delete. Okay. Do we need this metadata customizer? We can hopefully get rid of it. We need to delete some of these capture types. A lot of these switch cases based on the class is a bad coding practice. Instead, this code should have been in the class itself rather than some other class like main controller doing a switch. Anyway, we'll fix that later. Yeah, we are not adding raw. We don't have. So basically you have two different capture types, BGRA, which where you're taking a photo, VDO, which is video data output, where you're telling the system to continuously keep giving me video frames. But each of those frames is an image, so you can treat them as images. So these are the two things, and this is a synonym for BGRA, except that in the UI it shows differently. These should be removed, these statics, because they are global variables. You can't control who uses them. Yeah, raw format is always zero, which means it's not an image. Processed format equal to this. Now we can see if we can remove this further. Switch to a two argument constructor. I'm sure you can, just confirm it. Oh, you can't. This is what we're using. I wanted to eliminate the first argument. Processed format and bracketed settings are the ones we want. This doesn't take bracketed settings. Yeah, you have to pass it even though it's zero. Zero. We have a two argument initializer. I'm wondering whether we can supply only a processed format. I think we can, we saw it earlier. Oh no. Oh, it's just called format. let's check this again. Okay, I think we are done with this. Let's look at the divs. Only commented code here. Not only does this reduce the code, it reduces the number of code paths, the branching, which otherwise becomes hard to deal with. There's so many, you know, paths you can take, so many different classes or. Different functions, different paths within the function. Hopefully this class is defined and never used. Awesome. What else can we delete? Remove multi-time-lapse functionality. So Futurecam add this feature where it can capture a time-lapse simultaneously from multiple cameras. We got that. I mean, we implemented that. We thought it would be a unique feature. We never got it to work well. So it was disabled. So now we are going to remove the code for that. Yeah, so the way the delegate, so let me tell you what the camera delegate is. It is implemented by the UI layer and it is used by the photography layer. So the delegate is how the photography layer asks the UI layer what settings the user has chosen, like which camera and so on. And all of these are independent properties, because multiple of these could return true, but we don't need that. We need only one. In fact, selected cameras can return only one, and our multiple cameras selected can be removed because they never selected. Our multiple camera selected will be false. So something and something and something is false here. Okay. Turn off multiple cameras should be first. lock, focus, and start recording. Like, I don't know why we are passing this parameter when this function itself could invoke the delegate. You need a space here to clarify that this comment is not for this, it's for this. This will always be true. I don't know why this code was written this way, because devices array, like if you look at the diff for frame producer, oh, I think it's checking for an empty array. But then, if there's an empty array, that means no camera is being used. Again, that scenario doesn't make sense. Okay, whatever. See what it does. It takes an array of cameras, it locks one of them, then it calls itself recursively to lock the remaining ones. Let's undo this change, we can always redo it. The most common mistake in refactoring is refactoring too much at once. So let's create an array with only one item. Keep this code as it is. So now they should. You have to change both the name and the type. Okay. We probably don't need. All of these getters. In fact, if you are going to redo this protocol, instead of making these the lower level and implementing this in terms of this, I would do it the other way around. Probably even get rid of all these, but if they must be there, it makes sense for this protocol to impose one requirement on its implementer rather than four requirements. So let's see if we can flip that. Let's do it step by step. You have changed the documentation. You have removed this R multiple camera selected function. Yes. You have changed selected cameras to selected camera and changed the code to return only one. You have removed the state code. Oh, this device's keyword should be there. He said zoom is true. Okay, never mind. Go back to the diffs. All right, this is done, and I'll see you in the next video.